Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're continuing on with our performance upgrades for the 7.3 Powerstroke, and today we're talking about intercoolers and intercooler upgrades. Now, an intercooler is probably going to be the least beneficial upgrade for power gain reasons, because you're not gonna notice a whole lot of power gains from an intercooler, but with that being said, it is definitely the best upgrade for reliability on the 7.3 Powerstroke. An intercooler upgrade is going to be the most beneficial if your engine's tuned, and also if you do a lot of heavy towing, you live in a hot climate, or you do a lot of driving at elevation or up and down hilly areas, and especially if you tow around those areas as well. The intercooler on the 7.3 Powerstroke is okay, especially at stock levels, but there is still a good reason for upgrading it, because you can see a number of performance related benefits as well as reliability related benefits. So in this video, I'm going to go ahead and talk about some of the performance and reliability reasons as to why you should get an intercooler upgrade. And then I'll go ahead and talk about a couple different upgrade options for the 7.3 Powerstroke. First off, from a power gain standpoint, on the 99 plus 7.3 Powerstrokes, you're not really gonna see a ton of power gains. You might notice some small benefits, maybe 5 wheel horsepower or 5 wheel torque, but the main reason to upgrade an intercooler is not for the power benefits, but more so for the reliability benefits. With that being said, if you have a 94 to 97 OBS 7.3, then you will see some pretty decent power gains from it. I haven't seen any dyno specifically, but there are a couple companies out there that claim about 20 horsepower and 40 torque from an intercooler upgrade on the OBS trucks, and that's predominantly because the OBS 7.3s didn't come with an intercooler from the factory. The 99 plus models do have an intercooler, and it's a decent intercooler, which is why you're not gonna notice a ton of power gains from upgrading it. But the biggest benefit is gonna come from EGT reductions. You'll see a 100 to 200 degree reduction in EGTs with an upgraded intercooler. And that's because an upgraded intercooler is gonna have a larger surface area and a larger internal capacity, which is gonna be able to more efficiently cool the charge air that's coming through it. It'll also help reduce your boost pressure drops. So it'll help you hold higher boost pressures. There are some benefits from that standpoint, but the biggest thing is that extra density and extra size that you get is gonna help cool the air down a lot more, which is gonna reduce your EGTs by 100 to 200 degrees. The other benefit from a performance standpoint is the reduction in heat soak. You'll notice a lot if you're towing heavily, you're maybe going up hills or in a hot climate, and you're using a lot of boost to do that towing, you'll notice that your EGTs are slowly climbing and climbing and climbing, and that's because of something called heat soak. Whenever a turbocharger starts to run really hot, it's gonna send hotter and hotter air into the intercooler. And if your intercooler is not good enough, it can pretty easily get overwhelmed and not be able to cool that air down efficiently. And so as the turbocharger gets hotter, the air gets hotter, the intercooler is not able to cool it down quickly enough, which means you're sending hotter air into your engine and therefore getting hotter exhaust gas temperatures. By upgrading the intercooler, you're gonna reduce all of that heat soak, which is gonna give you way more consistent performance. It's gonna prevent any heat soak issues, which is gonna allow your engine to run at a steady cool temperature all of the time, rather than what you'll likely notice of it getting overwhelmed and temperatures creeping up pretty high until you get into more favorable driving, where they'll then start coming down once your intercooler is able to catch back up with itself and effectively cool the charge air. So the biggest benefit is from a reliability standpoint, because you won't experience heat soak, you're gonna get a natural decrease in EGTs, you're overall gonna have a healthier running engine. And this is especially true when you're tuned and when you do heavy towing. Not only is this great for a stock truck that does a lot of towing, it is an essential modification for anyone that's looking to do a higher horsepower build. So on my 7.3 Powerstroke, I've got an intercooler, I've got an intake, it's tuned, and I've got an exhaust system running on it as well. I bought this truck to tow an 8,000 pound boat, and I do it out here in Colorado, where in the summer times it's 95 degrees. We're at 5,500 feet of elevation, and I've occasionally towed it into the mountains as well. And I'll tell you, towing an 8,000 pound boat, my EGTs have never gotten over 900 degrees, and that is predominantly attributable to the intercooler that I have on here. Now, an exhaust will go a long way in reducing your EGTs as well, but the intercooler is the biggest, most important factor in what allows my engine to run so cool while towing such a heavy boat, especially up hills, upgrades, and at elevation. The intercooler is, I would say, my favorite modification on my truck, just because my engine is so much healthier and so much more reliable because the temperatures stay extremely moderate. And there's no way that you'd be seeing EGTs like that if you didn't have an intercooler on it. Jumping into some of your upgrade options for the 7.3 Powerstroke, the biggest downside to an intercooler upgrade is that it is by far gonna be the most expensive upgrade that you can do to the 7.3 outside of throwing a larger turbo on there, building out your transmission. And that's because a full intercooler kit is pretty expensive. I run the Banks Techni-Cooler on my 7.3. The Banks Techni-Cooler comes with intercooler piping, but when we look at an intercooler versus intercooler piping and up pipes and all of the other things that you can do associated with an intercooler, really the intercooler is the thing that matters most. You don't get a whole lot of performance benefits or gains from upgrading the intercooler piping or the up pipes. And so I recommend just getting an intercooler if you can. Now, if you don't have $1,700 to spend on an intercooler, there are a couple other options. CSF makes a couple intercoolers for the 7.3 that are good. One of them is the CSF Heavy Duty 7107, which is a good heavy duty intercooler only upgrade for the 7.3 that runs about $900. That's gonna be the best option if you're looking for just the intercooler only and you don't want the more expensive Banks option that comes with all of the intercooler piping as well. The CSF 7107 is gonna be the best intercooler only upgrade, but there still are a couple other things to talk about. And one of those is a 6.0 Powerstroke intercooler swap. So you can swap in a factory 6.0 Powerstroke intercooler. It will have some minor benefits. You'll notice some lower EGTs. You're not gonna get the full benefit of going with something like the Banks intercooler or the CSF intercooler, but you will still see some benefits because the intercooler on the 6.0 Powerstroke is just a little bit bigger and more capable than the one on the 7.3, and it is a direct bolt-on as well. You can get a used one for probably $150 or $200, but if you're thinking about going that route, my recommendation would be sticking with a CSF. CSF has an intercooler, I think it's the CSF 6013, and that is what they call an OEM plus upgrade for the 6.0 Powerstroke. So it's an OEM replacement for the 6.0 Powerstroke, but they throw the OEM plus on there because it is slightly bigger and does have some small performance benefits over the factory 6.0 intercooler. So I'd recommend, if you're gonna look at getting a 6.0 intercooler, getting the CSF 6013. It's $425, so it's about half the cost of getting a full-on intercooler upgrade for the 7.3 and only an extra $150 over getting a used 6.01. I'd go that route if I were looking at dropping a 6.0 intercooler in there. Those are, generally speaking, your three best options right there is the Banks Techni-Cooler if you have a higher budget or need maximum cooling and maximum benefits. If you're looking for a more budget-friendly but full upgrade option, you're looking for all of the benefits, then I'd recommend the CSF 7107. And then if you need a new intercooler for your 7.3 or you're running relatively modest power levels and just want a little bit of improvement, then I'd recommend the CSF 6013. Anyways, guys, that covers it for intercooler upgrades for the 7.3 Powerstroke. I was planning on showing you mine, but the intercooler is tucked into the engine to a point where there's not really anything to see or to show you, but I hope this was helpful. If you guys have any questions, go ahead and reach out to us in the comments below and head over to boostedperformance.com. We sell the Banks Techni-Cooler, we sell both of the CSF intercoolers, as well as a number of other performance-related products for the 7.3 Powerstroke. I own one of these things, I have a ton of experience with them, and we have a ton of products for your 7.3, so go ahead and drop us a contact us on there or respond to this video, and I'll go ahead and do my best to help you out and hook you up with the parts that you need for your 7.3 build. Thanks, guys. Go ahead and click the like button and subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you for our next video on the 7.3.